First quarter, no score. Curtis Enos gets outside, and he is gone. 39-yard touchdown run, 7-0 Penn State. Second quarter, Wally Richardson hooking up with Joe Juravicious. He is vicious. Breaks the tackle, gets a block, and help is not on the way. 63-yard connection as they are happy in Happy Valley, 34-9. After being benched last week, Wally Richardson comes back throwing two touchdown passes. Northwestern's 13-game winning streak in the Big Ten is over, and perhaps so are their road. The third quarter, Gophers trailing 17-0. Quarterback Corey Souders' pass picked off by Andy Katzenmoyer. Like that name, Katzenmoyer, 42 yards for the touchdown. Yeah, rerun. He's getting down. Yeah, a sort of rerun. And I got a pair of striped shorts just like that. Don't wear them often. You're right. 45-0. Buckeyes up their record to 8-0 despite turning the ball over four times. Pepe Pearson ran for 123 yards and two touchdowns. I just got the rerun line. The Golden Gophers have lost 12 straight conference games. The Battle of Michigan, the Wolverines and the Spartans, the flags upside down just like the Spartan defense. Michigan finishes the first half with a flurry. Scott Dreisbach finds Charles Woodson over the middle for the touchdown. Michigan scored three TDs in the final 2 minutes of the first half, and they roll 45-29. Scott Dreisbach with four touchdown passes. Michigan D came up with five turnovers. The Wolverines snapped the Spartans' three-game winning streak. 106,000 people on hand in Ann Arbor for the
Georgia rivalry. Florida has scored on every opening drive this year, but indeed, not on this occasion. Danny Werfel picked in the end zone by Ronald Bailey. That kept it scoreless early, but only early. Florida bouncing right back, already up 6-0. Werfel to Riedel Anthony in stride, splits the defense. Now it's 13-0 Gators. Still in the first quarter, Werfel once again going back to that Riedel Anthony well. He hit him from 20. And now he's got him from 21. That put Florida up 20-0. They have outscored their opponents 123-14 in the first quarter this year. They win this game 47-7. Werfel, 16 of 23. He had four touchdowns by halftime. Georgia did become the first team this year to hold Florida scoreless on its first possession of the game. And that, along with a year's supply of turtle wax, is a lovely consolation prize. Staying in the SEC, Tennessee, South Carolina, early second, tied at 7. Peyton Manning, matinee idol, scrambling and looking deep for Andy McCullough. Right over the shoulder, 48 yards. It's a brief highlight, but I believe one that sums up the game. 31-14, the final. Phil Fulmer called it one of the longest, hardest football games he's ever been through. His quarterback, Peyton Manning, threw for 362 yards, two scores. The Gamecocks playing without Deuce Staley, who is the leading rusher in the SEC. Third-ranked Florida State taking on Georgia Tech early second. Flat routes, always dangerous. Joe Hamilton picked by Lamont Green. 56 yards later, old Lamont has got a touchdown, 7-3 Florida State, and they don't look back. This man is Warrick Dunn. You know him as the top runner in the ACC, and this would be why. Breaking tackles, can he break it all the way down the sideline? No, but good for 51 yards. Big game sets up another touchdown, and the Noles roll 49-3 the final. It marks the third time this year the Seminoles of fourth-ranked Arizona State came to town. Jake Plummer under pressure throughout the first half. Not a memorable day for him, 11 of 22 sacked four times. Meanwhile, Oregon State's offense rolling on the ground. That's Beaver quarterback Tim Alexander on the option keeper. And keep he does all the way into the end zone for a 48-yard score. Oregon State up by 8 points. Second half, here's the kickoff, and Terry Battle taking it at the goal line into the shadows. Tough to see him in the shadows. Apparently nobody does, or if they did, they certainly didn't choose to tackle him. 100 yards and a cloud of AstroTurf. And he's got a touchdown. Sun Devils up 22-14 in the fourth. However, with 2.5 minutes left in the fourth, Oregon State down by 8. Alexander takes to the air for a change, and he is picked by Damian Richardson. Brings it back, gets some blocking from the defensive players. That would ice the game as he gets down to the 5. Arizona State goes on to win it by a final of 29-14. Terry Battle and Jeff Paulk each rush for over 100 yards. The Sun Devils still perfect in the Pac-10 at 6-0. The Beavers had 245 yards of offense in the first half, all of those yards on the ground. 21st-ranked Washington taking on USC late in the third. Huskies on the move. Brock Heward deep and down to the 1. Next play on that one, Corey Dillon powering in for the score. Dillon would reach 1,000 yards on the season in this game. Hands up, UW winner, 21-10. Dillon carried the ball a school record 37 times for the Huskies. He gained 128 yards. The Husky defense sacked Brad Otten 7 times and held the Trojans to, can you say that, to minus 14 yards rushing. Moving on, more from the Pac-10, Arizona-Cal, record-setting day for Pat Barnes. Roll right with me, Pat, and he does, avoids the sack. That looks like the play almost. Back of the end zone. 14 yards and a score. Meanwhile, Barnes again to Demaine Douglas over the middle. 18 yards and a score. Game goes into overtime, tied at 35. Fourth overtime, we skipped a little bit. Barnes rolling right, avoids the sack again. There's Mark Vera in the front of the end zone. Wait till you hear the numbers on Barnes. I'm going to keep you in suspense. 56-49, Arizona answering. Then the fake kick and the pitch stuffed at the line. And after four overtimes and seemingly 6 or 7 days to complete this game, Cal 56-55 in overtime. I'm not sure we did four overtimes justice there. Pat Barnes, how about this? 503 yards, 8 touchdowns passing. Both of those.
Bride's team ranked 20th. This game was all Rice. They like the option, the pitch. Chad Nelson out to Spencer George. Spencer for hire. This guy's going to cut all the way across the field. And they won't catch him. 76-yard touchdown as the Owls win their fourth straight game. They're on a roll. 51-10. Man, Rice ran for 496 yards, snapping Utah's 7-game win streak. The Owls have rushed for more than 400 yards in four straight games, during which time they've completed only 7 of 21 passes. Who needs the pass? Still in the whack. Lowly UTEP against BYU. BYU up 12-3, and here is the second half kickoff. James Dye of the Cougars with a return to die for. Only the fourth Cougar in history to run for a 100-yard touchdown. If he makes it, and he does, BYU up 19-3. Now, would you believe we would have a game with two 100-yard touchdowns? Steve Sarkisian picked off in the end zone. It's Michael Hicks, and Hicks is going to go coast to coast. He had two interceptions in this game. However, it was not enough because BYU was in control handily, 40-18 the final, but a couple of great plays there. Steve Sarkisian goes 22 for 30, 235, and 2 touchdowns. BYU takes over first place in the Mountain Division because of Utah's loss. James Dye, third quarter, Huskers up 17-0. Oops! Oklahoma quarterback Eric Moore on the slant, picked off by Ralph Brown. Watch the downfield blocking. Nebraska guys used to turning turnovers into touchdowns. Terrell Farley, the key block, as Nebraska rolls 73-21, 73 points, the most ever allowed by an Oklahoma team. Scott Frost, 3 touchdown passes. The Husker defense picked off 4. It's Nebraska's 6th straight victory over their old rivals. And it was Colorado over Missouri, 41-13. Coy Detmer throws for a school record 457 yards and 3 touchdowns. Detmer now has 35 TD passes, breaking Cordell Stewart's old school record. The Buffs have tamed the Tigers 12 straight times. Brett?
Moving on from the ACC, North Carolina, NC State, first quarter, NC State with the ball. Jamie Barnett. Fumble, loses the ball. Who's got it? In the end zone, it's Kavusima Mays recovering it. Touchdown, 6-0 UNC. Second quarter, Wolfpack punting. Snap is low. Jay Dukes. Punt is returned by Leon Johnson. Breaks a tackle. Gets his ankles free, and the rather short touchdown return is 39 yards. And Tar Heels win it 52-20 on special teams. Brian West back to punt. Deion Maddox gets a piece. There he is. Avoids the pressure. Finds a seam left side. And there he goes. 72 yards and a score. 7-0 Orange lead. Second quarter. Paul Pasqualoni all fired up. Again, it's a punt situation. And this time it is blocked. Phil Nash breaks in untouched. His second block of the day. Syracuse would score on the ensuing drive. Now it's 30-7 closing moments. It's an onside kick, and I'm pretty sure the rules indicate you got to kick it forwards in order for it to be eligible for reception. It's a 30-7 Syracuse win. Phil Nash blocking the 2 punts, and their defense holding West Virginia to minus 10 yards rushing. That's the lowest total in Don Nealon's 17-year career. Meanwhile, 22nd-ranked Miami at Temple. Miami winning this 57-26. What about the
game traveling to Dublin? to play Navy. Third quarter, Irish in control 21-7. Navy quarterback Chris McCoy hit by Corey Miner. That's a major problem. Fumble, Ronaldo win, 24 yards, touchdown. And we love Ireland. 54-27, the Irish have beaten Navy 33 straight times. That is the most consecutive wins ever by one NCAA team over another. Mark Edwards, three TDs. Autry Denson, 14, not anymore. Lee Roberts to Kendrick Lee. Nice adjustment to come back for the ball. Southern Miss wins 21-17. They clinch at least a tie for the Conference USA title. Roberts, three TD passes. Southern Miss has won seven in a row. Second straight game in which the Golden Eagles have come from behind in the fourth quarter to win. SEC football, Arkansas and Auburn. Terry Bowden, Damian Craig, what do we call? Early fourth quarter. Look out, Damian. How does he get away? And then the composure, 26 yards to Tyrone Goodson for the touchdown, as Auburn is a winner 28-7 after being blown out 51-10 by Florida. Story of the game is this guy, Reginald Johnson, sweeping 13 yards for the touchdown. That's touchdown number one for New Mexico. Second quarter, Johnson again, short yardage. That's easy. 13-6 New Mexico, two TDs. Here he is on the draw. And out of my way. Three TDs for Johnson. Fourth quarter. All right, that's easy again. That's four TDs. One more time on the sweep. Here is Reginald Johnson for number five. Reginald Johnson, he's a bad man. 34-23 New Mexico. Johnson runs wild, 232 yards and a school record five touchdowns. New Mexico is actually down by 11 points in the third quarter, but they score the game's
At Texas, Longhorns already up 14. Richard Walton screen pass to Ricky Williams. I believe he's got some open field in front of him. Cuts back midfield, 46 yards and a touchdown, 21-0 Texas. They hang on, 28-23. Stanford, the tree, and UCLA, fourth quarter, buck to go, 20-14, Stanford down. Chad Hutchinson has the ball, looking and finding Brian Manning back at the end zone in the corner, 10-yard score. Stanford comes from behind, wins it 21-20. San Diego State, San Jose State, Aztecs up by a bunch. Billy Blanton looking for Nate Jacquette. 28 yards on a leaping score. Blanton's fourth pass of the game for a touchdown. Aztecs win 49-20. Game of the night, as you saw here on ESPN, Colorado State Air Force. Quarterback Bo Morgan breaks a tackle. The kid likes to run. He's a quarterback, but he might as well be a running back because that's what he likes to do. He's gone. 77 yards, one of four rushing touchdowns for him. But wait, 41-14 in the second half, fourth quarter. Now it's Moses Marino up for Jeremy Calhoun. What a catch is that? How about a tie game at 41? A celebration penalty for the extra point makes it extra long, but Mac McDougal, true to the test from 35 yards out. Drama, pathos, Falcons, last chance, 41 seconds. Morgan hit as he releases. And you know what happens when that happens? It's picked, and you love to see the quarterback go after the lineman. He's feisty, he's spunky, and it's a win.